Hey everyone, this is Manly Badass Hero. Welcome back to Zero Time Dilemma. Previously on Zero Time Dilemma, we created another time paradox which led to the events of Virtue's Last Reward. And now, as we near the end of the game, we return back to our effort team to find out how their time paradox is going. So if I had to take a gander, this is going to lead me to my other missing ending on my save file. And it's just called Q. Ooh boy.
Why? Why?
Shut up! He was trying to make me look the fool! He probably figured I wouldn't shoot! Looks like he figured wrong!
No! No!
Hey, cut that out, Eric! No. I won't stop. Not until you're all dead!
Can we just get rid of Eric?
Why?
Didn't I say already?
Okay, we'll use your super strength.
It is one of us. It is the one who killed Mira. You, isn't it?
I told you, it's not!
You're gonna have to prove it!
Prove? I don't have any...
Then I'm killing you.
Wait! Please, wait! I know. Maybe...
Deep into that computer brain of yours.
Maybe what?
Maybe if I take this helmet off, I think you'll understand then.
So, your face will prove your innocence? Fine. Take it off.
And there was a split in the thing. I wonder if this is based on that. Like not being able to put the code in.
The number for this is... I think it's...
Like we know what the code is. Let's see what happens at the bad end first.
You bastard! You're fucking with me, aren't you?
Do you actually bleed? Doesn't look like it.
Oh God.
No choice is made.
What? Are you serious?
It can't be.
No!
They said as none of their lips moved?
Yeah. Not human.
That makes you even more suspicious.
No, it's because I'm not human that I can't be.
What do you mean?
My blood, it's white. Not
that's really stereotypical.
Red.
So what?
Remember how Mira had some skin and blood under her nails? Wait, well, I guess you wouldn't because of the memory loss, but...
No. You're right. When I tried to revive Mira, I took a look at her.
Let's check up Eric's body. I wonder if he has any scratches
then
on there.
You realized... I think the skin and blood is that of the killer. Before Mira died, I think she did her best to resist.
I see. I suppose you're right then. You didn't kill her. But no! It doesn't change the fact that you existing is suspicious! I mean, come on! Why is a robot here?
Well... because Zero brought me in.
What the?
Zero created me so I could support him in this game.
I knew it!
Wait, Eric!
Out of my way! I'm gonna kill him!
Please, just calm down, Eric!
Shut up!
If what he said is true, then he would be able to tell us who Zero is.
Think about it. You could take that shotgun and actually shoot someone important. You know, not us.
Do you? No?
This is gonna be another choice, where if I don't know, we all get shot.
Fine. If you know, then tell me right now who the real Zero is.
This is the way of the game to check you.
And
if you're not paying attention,
to take part in this messed up game.
To like the real obvious that you should like been bopped over your head at this
Zero.
Point.
Seems like. Name is.
Maybe you should have paid attention to the snail.
Why must I put this in? I wonder if he has custom dialogue.
Me? So you're saying I'm Zero? You fucking brat!
The beginning of the Joker. He was even told to always smile, right? Right there.
Oh, screw it! I'll just kill all of you!
Not Gab.
I'm coming to you, Mira.
Zero? The real Zero is? Delta!
I see you've spotted me. I've been hiding in the walls this entire time like a
Delta?
Ninja.
I've heard that name before.
Yeah, me too.
Oh yeah, you guys wouldn't know.
Oh god, it's a dog.
Because you transported into this history.
Oh, would you stop yapping, Sean? This old man's name is Q.
That's right.
That's what he was called at DCOM.
Yeah, I called him that. And Mira, she always called this man Q, too.
Then...
Oh, God. We've been here the entire time. I don't even know how that works.
He stood! This guy totally stood!
You're completely correct, Sean. My real name is Delta.
He spoke!
I thought you were supposed to be deaf. Okay, and here we are. All of you will be living together here in the DCOM facility.
The old man in the wheelchair, too?
His name is Q. It should be obvious, but he can't walk. What's more, he can't see or hear either.
He can't hear?
Nope.
But then why?
Strangers living together on Mars for an extended period of time? What kind of problems would that bring? How would the subjects figure out solutions to the resulting troublesome situations? According to the DCOM staff, that's what the experiment was trying to determine.
Like the chair-bound old man. He put us in a difficult position on purpose. To observe how we get out.
This is
so
the...
You're saying it...
This is the perspective twist of this game.
It's all a lie.
Every single one of these games has a perspective twist.
Lies.
Turns out that's just really weird.
This is...
There are a large variety of security cameras in place throughout the shelter. A feed of all the footage is fed in, and they all appear there.
So, you used that to spy on us the whole time?
Yes, I did. However, it is limited to those histories where I am alive.
Is he supposed to represent the player character?
Histories? Hey, Sigma, go take off his clothes.
Huh?
Just hurry and do it!
There is no need. This is what you wanted to see, correct?
You bastard!
Hold on, don't do it, Eric!
If you shoot, we won't be able to ask him anything.
Was it you who killed Junpei, too?
No. Mira was the one who did that.
What?
She was, in a sense, a collaborator. She was a necessary element of my plan. But it wasn't that I gave her a specific set of orders. I simply let her roam free and do as she pleased. Oh, I did exempt her from the drug injections.
Then why? Why'd you kill Mira?
She's a serial killer. The Heart Ripper. Many innocent people lost their lives because of what she's done. I only gave her her due punishment.
So now, then I would guess...
What are you talking about?
We were Zero.
Stop bullshitting me!
We've been viewing the different timelines with the glasses.
In another history, you and Diana and Sigma were all murdered by her.
Shut up! You're just making shit up! I will never believe you! There's no way my angelic Mira would ever...
No, Eric! Don't shoot! We haven't asked him everything yet!
Shut up! I don't care! The X door will never open again!
It'll open. Of course it will.
What?
So, should we ask him, Hal?
Right. The old man, Delta.
Because the one ending with the Mexican standoff, when they shoot, it looks like they're shooting you. So, like I said, I guess he is the player. That's the big twist.
I see. I get it now.
The reason no one talks to you is because they think you're deaf.
I mean, Sean. He needs to get direct access to the central control computer. Is that right?
But...
What?
To connect to it directly, I need to extend a cable from my neck and plug it into the console jack that's inside. But, well...
It looks like the cover is shut.
Yeah. We would need to open this first.
What's the code?
Code?
Don't play dumb. The code to open the damn cover.
It's 38080832.
It opened.
Now we just need to extend the cord and connect it. Okay, it's ready.
All right, that's a little weird.
Just wait a sec. I'll open the X door.
Why do we keep letting Eric have that shotgun?
Huh? Why?
No, no, I... My hand just...
I have no more use for this history. There's only one thing left to do.
No! Wait! Don't...
He is a player character. That's why you can purposely go for the bad ends. It's you who is Zero Q making the decisions.
Mom.
Zero said as his lips didn't move. So in the first Zero Escape, the perspective twist was the whole, essentially, you weren't actually playing as Junpei or the others, you were playing Akane, kind of in Junpei's perspective with the whole morphogenetic fields. So we were actually playing as two characters at the same time without realizing it. And the second game was the whole, Sigma's actually an old man. There's some perspective stuff going on with that. And this one, the perspective thing is... You are actually Zero, aka Q. And who you thought was Q was never actually referred to as Q. And... You've been... All the perspective
of the rooms. The reason you always see the perspective of the rooms is because you're in this old, what is assumed to be a blind, deaf man in a chair that they just ignore every time. It's one of those Kojima-esque twists. If you know what I mean. If I had to describe his motivations, I feel like... I feel like the true motivations, is, like I said, is to both ensure his own existence and also ensure an ideal timeline in the end, where everyone lives and the Radical Six doesn't get out. But he does mention there's a big terrorist attack that wipes out almost all life on Earth. So, I feel like I said, he's reaching for an ideal timeline somehow. Where Radical Six does have to go out into the universe and stop the terrorist attack to start the events where he's born and all that jazz. Because if it doesn't, then no one stops that thing, and which doesn't stop that. And he also needs to ensure that everyone lives, I'm assuming, which is why the game is set up the way it is. It's that way they can both stop Radical Six while still ensuring his birth, while maybe possibly stopping the terrorist attack. On and on. I don't know why he has shifting morphogenetic field powers that are so powerful, like, it seems a little bit off the scale for a lot of these characters. Well, it's part of the glasses. He somehow has made shifting glasses, I guess. Well, there's literally only one thing left. And that's the United Rock, the boxes. And I believe he gave us something in the Carlos ending, so... This should take place after the acid rooms, if I'm correct.
What?
He's given everyone a code they need to open these boxes.
Is this?
It looks like a device of some kind.
Hey, look! Something's appearing on the monitor.
To execute the Force Quit program, the central control computer must be booted.
Central control computer?
Wait, did we ever see something like that in here?
That's up to Q team this time.
If there isn't, then we're out of luck.
Dead end, huh? Hey, Carlos, how did you know that password?
I'm not sure.
What?
I don't know how I knew.
This is just a guess, but... Carlos, did you possibly shift from another timeline?
Wait, shift?
Shift. Shift.
Damn, we died a lot.
Oh, so it was like that then.
Hey, come on. You're the only one to figure it...
Sorry, just... Could you be quiet for a second? I need to think about something.
You've been sitting here for an hour, Carlos. Could you maybe share what you've been thinking about?
Do you want to know?
Yes.
I was thinking about you, Akane.
Me?
You're, well, to be blunt, really hot.
Huh?
We may never manage to make our way out of the shelter. You know what that means. Right.
I'm sorry. I'm not sure.
What the hell are you getting at, you asshole?
Oh, look. A Neanderthal is trying to block my way.
What? Wait, what the hell?
You're trying to trigger your ship skill?
No! Please, stop this!
Shut the fuck up! You bastard!
Or is it Zero controlling them somehow?
What the? Hey! Wait up! What the hell are you doing, Carlos?
I suppose I couldn't control myself.
You asshole!
What? Is that all you got?
You didn't run to like where they originally first shifted.
That's the extent of your feelings for Akane, huh?
Damn you! Ah, that was a good one.
Oh, I can tell you're finally getting fired up over this.
Shut the fuck up! You fucking asshole!
Considering Carlos was blocking the punches from my giant cyborg thing earlier. He's actually pretty swole and durable.
Carlos, are you alright?
Yeah, that was nothing. Anyway, hey man, what do you say to a drink?
What?
To clean the slate between us. Come on. This one'll work fine. Ah, damn it. I blame you for this, Junpei. My hands are all shaky after your brutal punches. Sorry, but could you guys help me clean this up?
What the hell?
I'm still wondering if he's being controlled and being weird or trying to trigger something.
Thanks, guys.
Sure.
No, he's going out of view of us,
guys,
the player character.
Time.
You're right.
Now it is time for you to sleep. When next you wake, know you will have no memory of these past 90 minutes. Pleasant dreams.
That's why, because the view cut out in like the little small frames when they go down behind the counter and he's out beating him up. He's using it as a distraction, a really realistic one that's kind of poorly acted to be able to talk to Junpei or the rest of them. The items have received.
Diana?
What's gotten into you?
This sounds complicated.
Oh, Fi! What? No.
Yeah, these are your parents.
Diana,
You're technically a clone of a timer paradox, baby.
Sigma!
You don't have to say anything. This is enough for now.
Now, force quick cue.
It opened!
Now all we have to do is insert the plug here.
So where is this plug?
I think... if we input the right numbers here...
What?
Wait. What do numbers for your head have anything to do with the plug for this?
I should just do it. You might get it then.
Stop avoiding the question!
Do you even know what should go there?
The numbers are,
Do I have to enter them manually again? Alright, I think we're on a straight shot to the end of the game now.
Are you kidding me? You're...
It's been an hour. Would you just get used to it already?
How can I? I mean, he's... It's a robot! For real? Could you maybe do something about it?
Is this better?
Yeah. Now the shape brings out your eyes.
They're very
so
nice.
This doesn't freak you out or anything, at all.
I could see the same to you.
Well, not much phases me. I'm just not that type. You could have been a Martian for all I care.
Yeah, I was surprised when I first found out. I thought my heart was in my throat.
You don't have a heart.
Hey, hold on. Did you say when you first found out?
I meant, it happened to me before. In the past. In another history.
Another?
I remembered everything. When I saw what I looked like earlier. You see, my brain isn't located in this head. My thought center is there, inside the quantum computer. That is where I think, perceive, and send command signals to this body. For example, when I raise my hand like this, it's simply receiving a command. Just like a remote-controlled toy. Did you know? A quantum state is one where all possibilities overlap and coexist. This quantum computer, then, is able to use this state and run, say, simulations A, B, and C simultaneously. Basically, my brain is an infinite number of worlds and possibilities. So I can use that framework and, well, jump between other histories.
Oh, there's no way.
It's basically a forced shift.
But it's possible that you two might be undergoing the same thing. There's a theory. Human consciousness may be a result of quantum effects in the brain.
Here we go, it's quantum mortality.
Quantum mind. It's more or less suggesting a human brain is a form of quantum computer. If a specific set of conditions are met, then you too can
jump to other histories?
This sounds like crazy talk.
You don't believe me?
Of course not!
Oh, I don't blame you. I guess I should explain everything then.
Please? Start at the beginning.
Before I begin, I need to do one little thing.
Huh, I never did realize your socks have the little power button symbol.
What did you just do?
Just a little something.
Oh no, it's messing with the security cameras and Q Delta's security glasses.
Nothing changed. Huh.
That we can see. But it looks like the message changed.
Yes, I started up the system earlier.
It says force quit program on standby. To initiate, two key items must be set. What does that even mean?
Wait, it seems like there's something else.
The key items are...
a mother's mementos?
I wonder what those could be.
So, this is saying we need to find them?
Does that mean they're hidden around here somewhere?
Even if that's true, I don't think we have the time.
Damn, guess our time's up.
Now it is time for you to sleep. When next you wake, know you will have no memory of these past 90 minutes. Pleasant dreams.
Is this the same for every route? Because it's United, so I probably click it. Yeah, blue was supposed to be last. To make most romantic sense. Okay, well, it's not a big deal. Blue seems to be generally last. Because I think it's like, you know, a personal connection to, well, Zero.
I knew it! Looks like the memories we regained are true after all.
The three wards were all in the same place. Then...
Carlos!
Akane. Junpei.
And Mira, and Eric.
I mean, I'm glad we're all alive, except for you and Mira and Eric.
Right? Carlos.
There's technically still a serial killer.
What happened?
Proof of friendship.
Anyway, what are you guys doing here?
According to the schedule, C-Team and Q-Team should both still be asleep.
We took a page out of your book and did what you did. We used the cards to keep the bracelet needle from injecting us.
So, does that mean?
Yeah. I remember everything.
I do too. Junpei and I as well.
Over the past few hours, we got back the memories we forgot.
Well, to be more accurate, it's more like we accessed the morphogenetic field and downloaded all of them.
Then you have the other history's memories too?
Yes.
Then you're like us.
But why?
Hold up. Eric and I are different.
Yeah. We didn't gain memories from other histories.
Then neither of you got injected?
No. We're the same as Carlos and the others.
I told them. Maybe I'll start from the beginning?
First, so I could run the program in the Force Quit Box, I accessed the central control computer. Then, I briefly turned off the communication network. That way, I stopped the surveillance cameras from sending any data to Zero. I didn't want Zero to catch on to what we were doing.
And that's when Sean let us in on the truth of what's going on here.
We went over to the transporter room and picked up two cards. Before the injection, we each slipped one between our wrist and bracelet.
Okay. Now you two make sense. But what about you, Sean?
Well, you probably already know, but I'm a robot. Being injected does nothing to me.
Then,
every time the time limit approached, I was forced to go into sleep mode. Then, my memories from the previous 90 minutes were deleted. I didn't want that to happen, so... You remember me saying I accessed the computer? Well, I hacked my own system, too.
So he said he managed to cancel the forced sleep and delete functions.
What about C-Team, then?
We couldn't interrupt the surveillance cameras, so we had to be sneaky instead.
First, Carlos pushed me down and climbed on top of me.
He what?
It was just an act. I was only pretending to do it.
Carlos used that moment to whisper in my ear. He said to go to the transporter room and grab the cards in there.
But if I just let her go like that, it'd look suspicious. So Junpei and I stayed behind to get Zero's undivided attention.
I wonder if you really suspected it or not.
I casually invited Junpei to the power room.
I feel like Junpei didn't know.
You can see the result of our conversation.
You should have told me what was up.
If I had, then Zero would have figured it out. You look like you'd be a crap actor.
Oh, you were so much better.
And after that?
We met Akane in the lounge. We hid from the cameras and each got a card from her.
Sorry, but could I get confirmation on something? Everyone knows what all happened in the other histories. right?
Even you, Mira and Eric?
Didn't Eric say so earlier? Sean told us everything.
But wait. Why?
Why what?
Why do we know about the other histories?
Well, that's probably...
I'll explain it to you.
You want to know?
Q? Or maybe it's actually Zero.
You are free to call me by my given name, which is Delta. There's no need to look so threatening. You were the one who named me, Diana. It doesn't matter. I shall answer your question. Carlos, Akane, Junpei, Diana, Phi, and Sigma. All six of you know that you are shifters, correct? Think back on your path to this very moment. Did you arrive at this history by following a normal flow of time? No, of course you didn't. You jumped in from another history using your shift abilities. And it wasn't just this once. You have been shifting back and forth many, many times. From one point in space-time to another. You boldly took chances. Much like jumping from one tree branch to another. You have forgotten that fact, perhaps as a result of the medicine, or as one of the side effects of shifting. Regardless, your memories have been kept firmly intact within the morphogenetic field. It is simply that the six of you regained the memories of those times. One small trigger, and the levee preventing you from remembering collapsed. Sean is a similar case. However, his thought center is located within the quantum computer, so I suppose it's slightly different from you.
What about me and Mira?
You are both like me, in that we do not have the ability to shift.
You don't?
He just uses those glasses.
I have another power instead. The power to mind hack.
Oh, okay, that makes mind hack sense.
I am able to read other people's minds. I know the thoughts and ideas that go through their heads. That's why I know exactly what Phi is trying to do right now. Step away from that device, Phi.
Then, when we blocked the injection...
I saw through your ruse.
Then why did you...
I wanted all of you to play the final decision game.
The final... decision game?
I find human decisions fascinating. More specifically, the world branching that occurs as a result. I already mentioned that I am unable to shift. But after looking inside millions of minds, I learned one thing. There are people in this world with the ability to jump between histories. That shifters exist. Hence, why I know so much about these parallel worlds.
You did all this? Because you were curious?
When a person does something significant, it It's difficult to boil the reason down to one word. Their motives are often very complex. It is the same now. To fulfill several objectives, it was necessary to trap all of you in here.
So why did you do it?
You want to know? It is so you give birth to Phi and myself, Diana.
I told you.
What do you mean?
Phi and I are the children of Diana and Sigma.
Phi is...
Wait. They're children?
November 16th, 2029. Phi and I were born in this shelter. This was another history, of course. Shortly after, the atomic data that makes up our bodies was transported to April 1904. The transporter was located in a German research facility at that time. Our bodies, reconstructed and regenerated in the export pods at that facility.
But that would mean you're actually...
I'm 124.
You're joking.
But Phi is...
A German researcher sent her to 2008. Records indicate that she was part of an experiment.
You're saying Phi jumped back in time from 2029 to the year 1904, and then forward again to 2008?
Have you ever seen Back to the Future?
What was sent both times was simply the data makeup of Phi's body.
I heard that in 2008, the device was being studied in an American facility.
That's when an old couple who were researchers took me in.
We've gone off topic.
Does that explain how you're able to mind hack?
Yes, that was one of the major goals.
Or how you're 124 and have purple
eyes. Everything
that
occurred here helped create Phi and myself. And when I say that, I am including all of the other histories. If I hadn't trapped the group of you here, then Phi and I would have never been born in our current forms.
Your current forms?
Sean, you should already know about epigenetics. You see, environmental factors determine which switches are activated within the genetic code. Reproductive cells are the same. Or perhaps I should say that the reproductive cells are the ones most affected.
Oh, I get it. That's why you made Diana and Sigma play the decision game.
What do you mean?
By backing them into a crisis situation, he caused an epigenetic change within their reproductive cells. I think that's why their children were born with unique powers.
Gold Star. This is the reason I have my mind hacking abilities.
Of all the things in this series, that someone is actually pushing it.
You were born a shifter.
The shifting actually makes sense because it actually has some ground in natural science.
Do you recall what was written on your wall?
But environmental factors triggering certain genetic codes.
Curious hate oozes calamity.
Giving you mind hacking abilities? That one's a little too Kojima.
No way. What you choose can materialize us.
Our decisions will bring you to life.
That is why the decision games were held. So that the Phi and me, here now, would materialize exactly the way we are.
No, but... Okay, so I get why you had to have Diana and Sigma go through life or death decisions. But the rest of us had nothing to do with...
I already told exact. You. My motives are complex.
Wait, there's more?
Plus you're all involved with the snail.
Ah! Fuck you, you goddamn old man!
Fine, no!
Right a kick! Oh god, Eric.
It's over.
You may be right.
What?
Diana, take this. Put it in. Your bluebird, too.
It's ready.
Verified. Key items were set. Executing force quit program.
Self-destruct begins.
Until explosion.
Escape, Samus.
What?
Oh, no!
The hell? What is this?
Hey, answer me! What's with that announcement?
Must I explain? This shelter will soon explode. You've worked so hard, only to turn on this facility's self-destruct mechanism.
Sean, access the central control computer.
It's no use. Once the force quit program has been activated, there is no possible way for you to reverse it.
Then what can we do?
I will tell you two good things. First, I suggest checking behind the bar counter.
Oh. Oh. No!
Why would you?
Gab. Gab's been...
Not the dog.
Did you kill Gab?
Yes, with the shotgun you're holding. There wasn't much life left in him anyway.
You monster!
I never expected to hear that coming from you, Sean.
So what's the other thing? You had two things to tell us.
I have the ability to mind hack.
We already know that.
And you're holding a shotgun.
I told you everything about it. Reading other people's thoughts isn't the only thing I can do with mind hacking. It only lasts a moment. But I am able to control someone's body as I wish. Like this.
No, for real, my finger just...
Mind hacking.
Understand now. This is my power. So,
and
let's begin. Your
after
final
what, Wesker?
Decision game. You have two choices. One, to stay here and wait to die. The other is...
Hey! What's the other option? What's the other option?
Thank you.
5 minutes until explosion.
What should we do?
What about the X door?
And how exactly should we open it? Unless 6 people die, it's gonna stay closed. Or should we start killing each other now?
Mira?
We know the X passes from literally every timeline.
I have an idea.
Which is?
We're going to shift, all of us, together.
Hey, hold on! Like, jumping to another history?
But Eric and I...
I'm sure it will be fine. Remember what I said? Human consciousness may be a result of quantum effects in the brain.
Oh, yeah. You said if certain conditions are met, we can also...
What are the conditions?
First, you need to be exposed to danger. And the other one is...
To be in the vicinity of a group of shifters.
I get it.
We'll resonate, and then Mira and Eric can...
But which history are we going to jump to?
Do we really want
None
to bring
the
them with
similar
us?
Similar histories will work. One team is likely to be dead after the vote.
And we can't shift if there are no bodies for us to jump to, right?
How about the coin toss?
And...
We need to jump to where all of us are alive.
When we're all alive.
Do you mean...
The history yep. where we won the coin toss.
I'm not sure I get it all, but it's a good idea.
What are you saying? There's no way we could do that.
Why not?
Shift isn't simply jumping into bodies in different histories.
Our consciousnesses swap places. Ours for theirs.
We'll be forcing our other selves into these bodies, and they'll die without knowing why.
Yeah, and what's wrong with that?
What?
Well, they're all living without a care off in another history, yeah?
One time? They do the coin toss once and win?
Don't you think that's unfair?
Mira, you're saying they, but we're talking about ourselves here.
Well, we should consider if those people really are us.
Yeah, screw ourselves.
Good point.
If we Never liked myself
that
anyway.
We here are the true versions, then... The us and the other history are essentially strangers. Even more of a reason not to.
If we shift to that history, then we're tossing the others under the bus to save ourselves.
The us in that history have done nothing wrong. I mean, the only thing they did was win at a coin toss.
You could say the same for us. The only thing we did was lose a coin toss. Even so, we've had to go through so much shit! We've been forced to put our lives on the line!
Besides, aren't the bodies in the other histories ours anyway?
Then why should we second-guess ourselves?
Huh.
One minute until explosion.
We're out of time! I'll say it again. We have two choices. We can stay here and wait for our deaths,
decision
or survive
game.
By sacrificing our other selves in another history.
So that's what that bastard meant. The final decision game.
Oh boy. I wonder if don't shifting is actually the true ending. It turns out that the actual, like, explosive alarm was just all fake. Oh no, something else unlocked there. But there's something also down here. Ooh. Payoff number 2.
Damn, I can't remember anything.
Me neither.
Neither can I.
It somehow feels like... like I made a bet with someone, but...
Someone?
What kind of bet?
Did we all forget what happened?
Hey, could I ask all of you something? Who is this kid?
So long, our ever selves.
Did we do it?
We're not wearing the bracelets, so I don't know the time, but...
Judging by the position of the sun, it's probably noonish.
And the date?
How would I know?
Hey, Mira. Eric. Do you remember me?
Yeah.
I definitely remember you.
Then we really did!
Now Mira can go on and kill again.
Life is unfair, don't you think? You bastard. 17 years ago, a snail traveled down a narrow path in the park. If that snail hadn't been there, perhaps all of you here would have lived a completely different life than you did. Just one small snail, and everyone's lives, even the world, changed.
So, what's the big deal? Ugh, would you just quit talking nonsense?
I'm so glad you were safe.
Of course we were. You all have shifted in from another history.
Whatever. We gotta call the cops.
And what exactly will that accomplish?
Isn't it obvious? We're throwing you in the slammer.
And
I've done nothing wrong.
Murder.
So we flipped a coin.
Murder? I see. But I haven't killed anyone. Specifically, in this history, not a single person has died. I strongly doubt the police would listen.
But in the other histories, you...
Did you not pay attention? I don't have the ability to shift. The only reason I know anything of those histories is because I mind-hacked you. In effect, the me you know is a different person than the one before you. Can I be charged for killing someone in another history?
Time police technically can.
Then I'd say this world would be full of criminals of all kinds.
What about conspiracy to commit?
Yeah. I'm betting this history's got a bunch of dangerous machines and gimmicks all over the shelter.
Unfortunately, I have removed them all. You've slept for quite a while. Nothing is left in the shelter. No transporter, no quantum computer. Loaded into a truck and taken away. Sean is able to move right now due to radio signals received from a satellite. Why? Aren't you happy? I say again, in this history, not a single person has died. Fi and I exist, and there will never be an outbreak of Radical Six. There is only a bright future ahead for all of us. Is this not what you'd call a happy end?
But according to you, all of mankind will die if time passes and nothing is done.
Religious fanatic, a terrorist attack that sparks a nuclear war.
I heard this story. You said you released Radical Six so that you could kill that person.
The me before you did not say that, but I can't deny it's true.
Radical Six won't spread throughout the world in this history.
That means that fanatic guy won't die.
Wait, so now humans will go extinct?
Hey, where's that happy future you mentioned?
You shifted into it.
Does that make you angry, Fine?
What?
If so, then we have a serious contradiction. I had prepared a future in another history where 2 billion would survive. But yet, you decided to jump to this history. That means you chose a future where humanity goes extinct, over 6 billion dead.
No, you're wrong, Delta. Nothing in the future has been determined yet. We'll shape the future with our own hands.
Huh. You said something I can get behind, Carlos.
I think so, too.
I agree.
Okay, me too.
Mira.
You're right. The future has infinite possibilities.
If we work together, we can accomplish anything.
Humanity's gonna die out? Screw that.
We'll definitely change that horrible future.
What's so funny?
Just that.
What the hell do you mean?
I'm sure I told you in another history that my motives are complex. Imagine. What if none of you had experienced the events that occurred in the shelter?
Then they'd never go out to try to stop the terrorists.
So determined now to change the future. One of the goals of all of this was to get you into that frame of mind. It's all going according to plan, without a single casualty. I created a future where mankind will be saved. Does that upset you? Are you angry that your life was played with? Very well. I will give all of you one last choice. With that gun there, you will be able to choose whether to kill me now or allow me to leave. I promise I won't use mind hacking on you. You are free to decide. Which shall it be? Pull the trigger or let me go.
The final decision.
The fates of you, me, and mankind are all on the line. This is the decision game.
Cut the credits, you bastards. So that's it for Zero Time Dilemma. This is technically the finale of the Zero Escape series. Not necessarily the final game, but it's supposed to kind of clear up all the loose plot ends and finish off everyone's story and everything. And I suppose it's up to debate whether or not this is a good way of fixing everything up. I mean, I don't necessarily sense plot holes or anything. It's a little bit weird, obviously. I don't like the mind hacking aspect. I feel like that's a little weird. Because everything else, like I said, it's kind of very science-y, and the mind hack is just, that's X-Men level stuff. But the rest of it, I suppose, works. It's a pretty complicated time paradox. I think it sometimes gets rid of some of the more simple, funner mysteries of the previous games. And it's kind of very over the top, but certainly it's actually not bad writing. It's actually pretty good writing overall. It's just comparing it to the previous ones. There is like a little bit of an epilogue with some text and everything. You can actually, I think, just go on the internet and read that. And it mostly talks about Mira and Q and Eric actually go create another time paradox to stop herself from like ever starting to commit these murders. And she did actually turn herself into the police and everything. Junpei and Akane, of course, get married, and overall, it's a happy ever after ending. I think the implication is that Carlos did not shoot Zero in the end. If they do make more in this series, I think they might be gonna deal with the terrorist attack or something like that. They might come back to that. Maybe a new cast and everything. But yeah, it's an overall solid, fun game. The twists aren't as powerful delivered as the previous two Zero Escapes. But it's certainly, like I said, it's much better than my opinion than actually Modern Telltale, which have good acting in them. But as far as natural game portion, I feel like they're already lacking now. In comparison, I much prefer the Zero Escape series. I feel like it has some very unique things that really are not captured in any other series out there. Also, before I go, a final comment. I'm actually going to list some of my favorite characters in that. Q-Team is actually probably the most dynamic and fun team here. In that they're just so bad and so terrible that they're a complete train wreck, and they're so enjoyable to be such a train wreck, and they're so enjoyable to hate that I feel like there were some of the standouts in the cast. Everyone else's story are mostly complete. Sigma's team is actually pretty good. Junpei's team, Carlos Junpei team, is actually, I think, probably one of the weaker ones of the group, because their stories have mostly resolved long before. Carlos's story is kind of not as invested into the situation. He's more of just a leader in search of the player. And in comparison, the Sigma cast is a little more varied and still has some like character flaws there enough where it's a little fun. But yeah, Q-Team, not necessarily the best characters as far as character morals, but certainly the most fun, stupid team in this entire game. But yeah, thank you all for watching me play Zero Time Dilemma. I'll see you guys later, and take it easy. Yeah, let's see if this ending's a little better, or if there's a big twist to this one. Oh no, it blew up, everyone died.